where it gets awkward. Right now, Medicare has determined that if you have a COVID-19 admission to the hospital, you'll get paid $13,000. If that COVID-19 patient goes on a ventilator, you get $39,000. You get $39,000. You get $39,000.
What's up, YouTube? It's Rose Flex, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I have great news to share with you. Yesterday, on Fox News, Dr. Scott Jensen further made known the corruption behind the global pandemic. I'm making this video to let you know that this virus is not as deadly as the fear porn media makes it out to be. Now, David Icke did this as well, and also David Wilcock, but Dr. Scott Jensen yesterday on Fox News told us that doctors make a large commission if they classify a death as COVID-19 or even put a patient on a ventilator. Like I mentioned in my previous video, the system is set up this way to make it very easy for doctors to classify a patient as having COVID-19, although they do not have it. The RT-PCR test does not test for COVID-19. It tests for genetic material that is inflammation. So any illness that has inflammation involved can show up as COVID-19 on these tests. And Kerry Mullis, the inventor of the RT-PCR test that is being used to diagnose COVID-19, the inventor of the test said that we should not be using this test to diagnose infectious disease. Let's get into the video.
Dr. Fauci was asked about the COVID death count today. Here's what he said in part.
What do you say to those folks who are making the claim without really any evidence that these deaths are being padded, that the number of COVID-19 deaths are being padded?
You will always have conspiracy theories when you have very challenging public health crises. They are nothing but distractions.
Conspiracy theories, doctor? So you're engaging in conspiracy theories. What do you say to Dr. Fauci tonight?
Well, I would remind him that anytime healthcare intersects with dollars, it gets awkward. Right now, Medicare has determined that if you have a COVID-19 admission to the hospital, you'll get paid $13,000. If that COVID-19 patient goes on a ventilator, you get $39,000, three times as much. Nobody can tell me after 35 years in the world of medicine that sometimes those kinds of things impact on what we do. Some physicians really have a bent towards public health, and they will put down influenza or whatever because that's their preference. I try to stay very specific, very precise. If I know I've got pneumonia, that's what's going on the death certificate. I'm not going to add stuff just because it's convenient. I think that it's not
a conspiracy
theory at all.
You reject what he said.
Absolutely.
Well, it's interesting that in Italy, where socialized medicine, I guess they don't have an interest in the money, if that's what it is here, and they just went back and they started reclassifying deaths, according to their top scientific advisor. So they admitted that they were being liberal or generous in how they coded some of these deaths, and they're just going back and reclassifying them. Does that surprise you?
I mean, let's just take someone getting hit by a bus, and they collapse along, and they go into the emergency room, and they're there for 15, 20 minutes, and blood work comes back, COVID test comes back positive, and they die 20 minutes later because of their collapsed lung. We're going to put that down as COVID-19? That doesn't make any sense.
As you have just seen, many countries around the world, including Italy, are now going back and reclassifying all of these COVID-19 deaths. I understand that the censored David Icke video, which is now up on his website and London Real's website, I know it's 2 hours long and you probably don't want to watch it, but he explains in it that if you compare the death data from last year, people that were dying from cancer and heart disease, we're actually doing better this year. All of a sudden, everybody is not dying from cancer and not dying from heart disease anymore because they're reclassifying these deaths as COVID-19. So that's why the data is all construed, and it's very obvious when you compare it with previous years. Like I said in my previous video, if you fall down the stairs and break your leg, you're having to go to the hospital for that. They're going to test you for COVID-19 right when you walk in the door because that's just what they're doing. And if you happen to die because of massive blood loss, or a collapsed lung from falling down the stairs, it's going to be written off on your death certificate as having died from COVID-19. Now, the tests that are testing people, they are the RT-PCR test that I explained in the beginning of the video. The RT-PCR tests, they only test for genetic material. It's very easy for anybody that has inflammation to get a positive on this test. It's very inaccurate, and it's recommended by all of the foundations by Bill Gates that we are following for some reason. So the CDC is owned by Bill Gates. World Health Organization, owned by Bill Gates. The Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, owned by Bill Gates. So I hope that you learned something from this video. I hope that if a vaccine comes out under Bill Gates's paper trail, that you choose to not take it. It's very sketchy that he is denying that hydroxychloroquine is an effective treatment for this illness, and he wants everybody to take his vaccine. I don't trust him. I don't think you should either. With that being said, I love you. I'm putting out this information because I care, and I hope you meditate tonight, and I will see you on the next one. Bye.